Welcome to the G&J Show.
She's Grace.
She's Josie.
Today is
the G&J Show Math Edition.
We got a question from one of our fans. She asked us how to complete an order of operations problem.
So today we are welcoming her to join us in our show and explain all about the order of operations.
Let's welcome Tatiana Foos.
Hello!
Welcome to the G&J Show.
Hello, again.
We heard you need help with completing an order of operations problem.
So today we'll be showing you and all our viewers how to use the PEMDAS strategy.
Let's get started.
Yay!
So when you're doing the PEMDAS strategy, you have to start with the parentheses, which is what the P stands for, which means you just do a 6, and then you bring down the rest of your numbers.
And then
multiplication.
There's no more parentheses. What I do?
So there's exponents, which we don't have. So we skip to multiplication, which is 18. So 18.
No, there's no more multiplication.
So then you do addition and subtraction, left to right. So
what's the D?
The D is division, but we don't have division. So this will be 28 minus 1, which is 27. And that's how you solve a basic order of operations problem.
So today I'm going to be helping us with the exponents portion of PEMDAS. So first you do our parentheses, which is 1 times 2 is 2. Bring the rest down. So, 10 to the second power, what is it?
10 to the second power is 10 times 2 equals 20.
No, it's not 20. When you have exponents, the number up here is how many times you multiply this number by itself. So it would be 10 times 10, which is 100.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. So we have 100 plus 2 plus 2 plus 3 minus 4. So then we do our addition and subtraction left to right. So this is 102 plus 2 plus 3 minus 4. So we have 102 plus 2, which is 104 plus 3 minus 4. Then we have 107 minus 4. Which it comes out to be 103.
Now I'm going to show you.
What does that mean?
That's exactly what I'm going to show you. So, of course, before I get to that, I have to start with my parentheses. So that's 5. And then bring the rest down. Now I have to do multiplication.
Mm-hmm.
When you have a dot in between two numbers, or parentheses, it means multiplication, which means this is 10.
So why do you put a dot and not just a multiplication sign?
Sometimes when you're doing algebra, and you can't use x because x can represent a missing number, so you use a dot instead. Okay, so
never mind.
So 10 plus 7 is 17. Minus 10 plus 2, 17 minus 10 is 7, plus 2.
It's minus 2.
Attention staff, at this time we are going to do our tornado drill.
Now I'm going to show you a different symbol for multiplication. So first I have to do my parentheses. And then multiplication. So this dot represents multiplication. Also, another way to represent multiplication is if there's no symbol in between two numbers, it means that you multiply. So 10 plus 17 minus 10 minus 2. 17 minus 10 is 7 minus 2. Which is 5.
So now I'm going to be giving a brief overview of what we have learned so far. So the PEMDAS stands for parentheses, which is what you do first, next you do exponents, then multiplication and division left to right, which you have to do first before these, but you can, like, if division's before multiplication, you do the division first because it goes left to right. Then you do addition and subtraction left to right as well, but after you do the multiplication division. So you have your PEMDAS, that's what it stands for. And then what so far we have learned that the dot, or even say you have a number and then it goes like that. This little space here means to multiply. And then we have also learned that exponents, say the number was 4 to the power of 2, you do not do 4 times 2. You would do 4 times 4 because you take 2, and that's how many times you multiply 4 by itself by.
After a brief intermission, we have the challenge problem. What do we do first, Tati?
That. Finish this problem. While you guys are talking about all this blibber blabber, I made up a song in my head. Cue it, Jay. PEMDAS beginning with a plus parentheses, oh please. Exponents are those numbers in the corner. It's not. Multiplication and division, it goes left to right. Addition and subtraction, they are the same. My hands up, get out, what she is. J. Now there's this another one. It's called Gem DOS. Don't worry, it is really, really easy. It's just the same. The G means groups and not parentheses. Well, technically, it's parentheses, braces, and brackets. Yeah.